students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in our previous session we have started our new lesson and the name of our lesson is what? Lesson number 8, reaching the age of adolescence. Okay, so in this lesson already we have seen some starting points. We have discussed about what is meant by the adolescence, what is meant by adolescence, what is meant by puberty. Okay, so in this same lesson today we will move for the next point, that is changes at puberty. Okay, so in our previous video we have discussed about that, what is my puberty, or what is, we can say that the puberty is the period in that what happens, the child is getting converted into an adult person, or in that phase the child becomes not a child as well, not becomes an adult also. There are the certain changes, certain physical, mental, intellectual changes happens in the child's body, but which are the exact changes happens in the body of the particular child that we are going to see in this point, that is what? Changes at puberty. Okay, so the first change we are going to see at the puberty period, that is what? Increase in height. So it is the most important or the most prominent changes that we can see during the period of puberty. So during this puberty the height of the child become get increased suddenly. Okay, so there is a sudden increase in the height at this period. What happens, the bones of the legs and the arms are getting increased in the size, that is the height in this period get increased. So initially the girls grow very rapidly as compared to the boys, but when both the reach to the age of the 18, their height gets completed, or their growth in the heights are getting completed. In some cases what happens, some are growing initially very fast and then the growth is get slow down. Okay, while in the other case what happens, in the some childs what happens, they are growing gradually. Okay, but at the age of the 18 their height is also getting completed. Okay, so the most prominent change we can see during the puberty period, that is what? The increase in height. But sometimes what happens, the bones of the arms and the legs are increase in oversize or out proportionate. Okay, means what we can say, that the legs and the hands become so long as compared to the other body organs. Okay, but after the certain period of the time, or as the time passes, what happens, that all the remaining body portions or the organs are get increased, and that time what we can say, that the whole body becomes in a proportionate. Okay, soon the other body parts also catch up, and as then becomes the result becomes what, the body becomes proportionate. Okay, so this is all about what, height. But here we are telling that in the puberty the height is getting increased, but the increase in height is also depends on the two factors. First one is that inheritance. Now what is meant by the inheritance? As we know, the genes are passed from the parents to the offspring, and the genes are responsible for the different types of the activities in our body. Okay, so if our parents are short, then it is the possibility that our heights become also short, or if our parents are tall, then our height will come also the tall. Okay, so that height of a person is also depends on the inheritance, as their parents are passing the genes from the parents to the offspring, then it is also possible that their heights will be similar as their parents. Okay, next one is there, or the next point for the increase in height is that proper nutrition. So during this puberty period, if you are taking the proper nourishment, or if you are getting the proper and the enough types of the nutrients, we can say that if you are having the proper amount of the proteins rich food, then it will be helps to build your bones and the muscles, and then your height will be proper, or it will helps to increase your height. Okay, so this is the first change that we can see during the puberty period. So in your textbook page number 114, there is a one chart is given. With the help of that chart we can calculate the height at a particular age. Okay, so according to the age what will be the height, or what is the percentage of the height in the boys and the girls, it is given in that table. With the help of that table we can calculate the height of the at any age of boys and the girls. We will take the one example, there is one boy of the 9 years. Their height is about the 120 cm. then what is the exactly height that we have to find at the end of the growth period? He is like B. To find out that, we are having one formula, and the formula is present height. What? Present height divided by percentage of full height. Percentage of full height at this age. Okay. So present height is what? 20 cm. So at the 9 years, what is the percentage height is that? And the percentage height is given 75%. Okay, what? 75%.
Why I have written 75%? Because he is a 9 years and he is a boy.
So in that column, for the boy column, 9 years, the percentage height is given 75.
So the present height is what? 120 cm, while the percentage of full height at this age is what?
75 cm. If we do the calculation, then it becomes what? 160 cm tall. Okay. So at the age or at the growth period, he is likely to be what? 160 cm tall. Okay. So with the help of that table, we will find out what is the particular height, or we can calculate full height. Okay. So this is all about what? Increase in height. Now we will move on to the next point, that is what? Change in body shape. Okay. Change in body shape. So at the puberty period, there are the certain changes. Most of the changes is happens in the body, but there are the some changes is happens in the body shape also. So during the puberty period, in the boys, the shoulders become so much broad. Okay, the shoulders becomes broad and the chest becomes wider. Why this happens? Because of the increase in the size of the bones. Okay, so these changes happens in the boys. While in the girls, the portion below the waist, is also gets wider. The portion below the waist in the girls, is getting wider. So what? These all are what changes which happens in the body. What? The shape, the change in the body shape is the body is changing now. And which changes happens in the girls and the boys? In the boys, the chest becomes wider while the shoulders become broader. Okay. And in the girls, what happens? The portion below the waist is getting wider. So these are why these changes is happens in their body shape, because of the increase in the, because of the growth of the bones. Okay. So this is what? Change in body shape. Now we will move on the next change, that is voice change, which is very important. So during the puberty period, there is a voice change also. If you have seen that in your classes, now the voice becomes changed. Why this happens? Because during the puberty period, there are the certain changes happens in the voice box or in the larynx. Okay. So we will talk about the voice. During the puberty period, the voice box or the larynx is growing, and the boys develops the larger voice box, and as a result, that larger voice box is comes out as a protruding part, and that we can easily see. Okay, see here in the image, you can see how the voice box of the boys comes out, we can say protruding out. Okay, or we can see it easily having, somehow it is having the like this structure, and that voice box that we can see easily from outside, it is called as what? Adam's apple. Okay, Adam's apple. But on the other hand, in the girls, the voice box is very hardly to visible, because it is small in the size, and that is the reason the boys during the puberty is having very deep voice, while the girls are having the high pitched voice. Okay, so this is what? Voice change. Why the voice change in the boys? Because during the puberty period, the voice box or the larynx started to grow in both boys and the girls. But the change only is that in the boys, that voice box or the larynx is comes out or protruding out, that we can easily see from outside, and that voice box of the larynx is called as what? Adam's apple, and that is the reason the boys are having the deep voice. But in the girls, we cannot see that voice box or the larynx because they are having the small size, and that is the reason the girls are having the high pitched voice. Okay, so this is the one more change in the puberty. In some adolescent boys, what happens? The voice box muscles can grow out control. Okay, or the overgrowth is happens in that. Because of that, the voice becomes like a horse, okay? But this stage remains for the certain weeks, and after the normal growth of that, it get change. Or this stage remains for the certain weeks or for certain days, and after a certain period, it becomes normal, okay? So this is the change in the, this is the next change in the puberty. Now we will move for the next change, that is what? Increased activity of the sweat and the sebaceous gland. Okay, so sweat gland is also called as what? Sebaceous gland. So during the teenagers, or now you are also the teenagers, you are also having certain changes in your body, and one of the prominent change we can see during the puberty is what? Increased activity of the sweat and the sebaceous gland. So the sweat gland and the sebaceous gland started to produce the more amount of the oil, and that is the reason the adolescents, like adolescents boys and the girls, are having the acne or the pimples on their face. Also their body started to produce the more amount of the sweat, and that sweat is having the particular type of the smell. Okay, why this happens? Because during this puberty period, the sweat and the sebaceous gland producing the more amount of the oil. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. And the remaining changes at the puberty we will discuss in the next video. And for today, thank you.